It was a script that I'd read, which stood out because I'm so bad at reading. Like, I'm so bad. I fall asleep, like, during everything. I was like, yeah, I really like it.
Make my cup of tea always before I read my script. Reading the script, you know, and tea went cold. So it was that kind of script, page turner, I think.
I think British independent films can sometimes be very grim and dark and grimy, and it's very much about how bad things are, grim up north kind of films. And this struck me as something that was doing something different. And the characters had such tenderness about them.
It's just a very cool film. There's something about it that it's hard to put your finger on it, you know, because it's not in your face. It's brave enough to go, you know what, we don't have to have a car chase every 5 minutes to make this interesting. We can actually have people in a hostage situation and examine that. You know, it's a hostage movie, really, and about the dynamic between the captives and the captors, you know.
You take apart a sort of received wisdom about crooks, about the gangster and the victim, and you investigate, you know, what goes on, what power struggle goes on, how roles are reversed, how, you know, things are revealed. And that's what appealed to me about the script, that on one level it's a very simple idea, but on the other, as you dig deeper into it, you see that it's a very, you know, emotionally, you know, intricate, and it's got a lovely narrative.
You'll be laughing at bits you shouldn't be laughing at, just remembering certain things in the film now.
And some of it's funny, you know, hopefully. If it isn't, you just cut the jokes and call it a drama.